I can neither teach nor live by the faith of others. I must live by my own faith, as the Spirit of the Lord has taught me through His Word. In 1524, an idealistic young man was ordained to the Roman Catholic priesthood and began serving in parishes in his native Friesland. Out of obedience to the Holy Father in Rome, he dutifully avoided reading the scriptures during his training, for fear that they might blur the accepted traditional interpretations. Over time, he became uneasy with the doctrine of transubstantiation, which was a definite problem since he was called upon to administer the sacrament on a regular basis. As a result, he was drawn inexorably to the scriptures and found no basis for such a transformation in the Mass. To further complicate his life, in 1531 a man was executed in another parish for the crime of rebaptism. And again, he was drawn to the Word of God. Horrified by his hypocritical life, he left the priesthood in 1536. Within a short period of time, he was a leader among the Dutch Anabaptists. Under his wise and gentle leadership, the increasingly militant Anabaptists were encouraged to embrace pacifism and separation from the world. We who were formerly no people at all and who knew of no peace are now called to be a church of peace. True Christians do not know vengeance. They are the children of peace. Their hearts overflow with peace. Their mouths speak peace, and they walk in the way of peace. Menno Simons took as his life's motto 1 Corinthians 3:11, "For no man can lay a foundation other than the one which is laid, which is Jesus Christ." The following hymn is an adaptation of his writings, his testament to the power of Christ in his personal life. He died in 1561 at the age of 65. Today the Mennonites still bear his name and adhere to his teachings. True evangelical faith cannot lie dormant. It clothes the naked, it feeds the hungry, it comforts the sorrowful, it shelters the destitute, it serves those that harm it, it binds up that which is wounded, it has become all things to all creatures.